Welcome, well, good friends. We're so excited to have you here today for our worship service. And for our friends who joined us today for the first time, we are so glad you're here with us. I'm Ate Julie, and I want to welcome you all to this Sunday's WoW God worship service. Now, I know some of you are celebrating their birthdays this week. We wish you a happy, happy birthday, and we pray that God will continue to bless you. Now, before we start, we need to remember that here in WoW God, we are free. F stands for being good followers and friends. R stands for being respectful and responsible. Respectful means that when someone's talking, we need to listen. Next letter is E. E stands for being energetic and excited. So when we're singing praise songs to God, we can sing and dance. And the last E stands for being a good example to everyone. So now, are we ready to worship Jesus? I hope you're as excited as I am. Okay, well, God friends, let us prepare our hearts and our minds as we worship our wonderful God.
Let us all rise for our call to worship. Psalms chapter 47, verses 1 to 2. All of you nations, clap your hands and shout joyful praises to the Lord. The Lord Most High is fearsome, the ruler of all the earth.
Come on, let's sing songs of praise for a wonderful God. Get your partner.
Thank you that you walk with us every day, that you are with us in each moment. Thank you that your promises are true and your goodness never fails us. In this moment, we come to you and we lay our lives before you. May we worship and adore you with every fiber of our being. May everything within us cry, "Holy is the Lord Almighty, who was and is to come." And so today, we join with all those who worship and confess you as Lord, from generations past and present. And with all the angels that sing in heaven of your greatness and beauty. All their thanks we pray in Jesus' name, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For your thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Kids, let me read a verse from chapter 32 of Psalms. When I kept silent, my bones wasted away through my groaning all day long. For day and night your hand was heavy upon me. My strength was sapped as in the heat of summer. Then I acknowledged my sin to you and did not cover up my iniquities. I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord. And you forgave the guilt of my sin. Children of God, we confess to God our sins with a promise that the Lord forgives us. Let us come to Him with our confession. Scripture is very clear that when you confess and approach God with humble heart, the promise is He will listen and He will forgive. The Lord in Christ's name has heard all our confessions with humble hearts, and so in Christ you are forgiven. Receive the forgiveness of God for all your sins and iniquities. In Jesus' name, amen.
This is the Bible. Its words are true. God gave His words for me and you. Now let's open our Bibles to the book of John, chapter 16, verses 7 to 8. If you love me, you will do as I command. Then I will ask the Father to send you the Holy Spirit, who will help you and always be with you. And from the book of John, chapter 14, verse 16. But I tell you that I'm going to do what is best for you. That is why I am going away. The Holy Spirit cannot come to help you until I leave. But after I'm gone, I will send the Spirit to you. The Spirit will come and show the people of this world the truth about sin and the judgment. May God bless us all.
Hi kids! We are still in our series about the Holy Spirit. So this morning, let me ask you some questions, okay? So the first question is, who was there since the beginning of time and was involved in the creation of the world? Who? That's right, the Holy Spirit. Next question. He helps people, even in the Old Testament, live for God. He was with David, Samson, Samuel, and all the judges and all the prophets in the Old Testament. Who is he? The Holy Spirit, that's right. Next question. He was involved in the birth of Jesus Christ through Mary. Who is he? The Holy Spirit. And the last one. He is a third person in the Trinity and is actively involved in the lives of Christians all over the world. The Holy Spirit. Good job. And do you know what, kids? That the Holy Spirit is also known as the Advocate, the Counselor, the Helper, the Teacher, Companion, Guide, and Life Giver. So this morning, let us take a closer look of what the Holy Spirit does in the lives of every believer. Yes, and that includes you and me. So what does the Holy Spirit do? What is his work? Let us see what is first. The Holy Spirit convicts people of sin. What does that mean? John chapter 16 verse 8 says, "And when he has come, he will convict the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment." The word convict means making aware or showing. So the Holy Spirit makes people aware of the darkness in their hearts and convinces them to repent and turn away from their sins and turn to God. The Holy Spirit tells people their need for Jesus. He is the one who gently leads them to the Savior, Jesus, to accept him, to receive him, and to follow him. No one becomes a Christian without the Holy Spirit. Second, so I see a black heart and a white heart. What do you think the Holy Spirit does? The Holy Spirit makes us new. He changes us. He gives us new life. The work of the Spirit is to change the person, kids, from the inside out. We are made new, transformed through the Holy Spirit. Remember our lesson a month ago about the popcorn seed and the caterpillar transforming into a popcorn and a beautiful butterfly and never going back to the way they were before? That's how the Holy Spirit works. He makes us a new creation. He makes us new. He changes us and transforms us to the image of Jesus Christ. And he seals us, showing that we belong to God and are sealed for salvation. He is now in us and will never leave us. The third one, I see a bell, which means that the Holy Spirit tells us when we sin.
every time we sin or are tempted to sin. The Holy Spirit warns us like a bell ringing. He warns us not to sin. And when we have sinned, He tells us that what we have done is wrong. Like when you're supposed to tell your mom or dad a lie, you hear like a little bell ringing in your head that you are not supposed to tell a lie. That's the Holy Spirit reminding you of the command of God to not tell lies and to always tell the truth. So we must always learn how to listen, kids, to the Holy Spirit's bell. He is holy, and He is in us to work God's holiness in our lives. So let us listen to His voice. He will encourage you and empower you to do what is right and pleasing to God. But there are times, kids, that we do sin. The Holy Spirit also reminds us to go to God, to ask for His forgiveness, and go to the person that you have wronged and say sorry to him. What do you see, kids? A Bible. Another work of the Holy Spirit is to guide us into all truth. The Holy Spirit reveals the truth to us through the Bible. He makes it real to us, and He helps us understand it and the good news of Jesus Christ. He protects us from the false teachings and from the words that may sound good but are not completely true. Like when somebody would say that there are other ways to heaven. You have to do this and that in order to get to heaven. You have to give a lot of money to the poor to get to heaven. But inside, you can hear the Holy Spirit say, no, that's not true. The scripture says that there is only one way to heaven, and that is through Jesus Christ. The Holy Spirit teaches us what is true, and that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Still on the Bible, the Holy Spirit helps us remember God's Word. Did you know, kids, that the Holy Spirit wrote the Bible through different men many years ago? So He helps us understand it. If we are faithful and study to memorize it, He will bring a verse to our minds every time we need it, and He will help us remember God's Word. He also brings verses to our minds to keep us from sinning. The sixth one. What do you see, kids? A child looking at the cross. Another work of the Holy Spirit, kids, is to draw our attention to Jesus Christ. He helps keep our eyes, our minds, and our hearts focused on Jesus. And when we look to Jesus, kids, we can always face the day with a smile, knowing that He is with us all the time. The seventh one, the Holy Spirit empowers us and helps us grow in our Christian walk. Just like a tree, kids, who needs nourishment to grow and bear fruit, we need the Holy Spirit to help us grow in our relationship with God and live a life that makes Him happy. He leads us to read the Bible, to memorize scripture by heart, and to pray every day. He encourages us and leads us and guides us so that we can remain faithful and strong against the enemy. And what's more is that He will give us the courage to share the gospel and to point others to Jesus Christ. The Holy Spirit helps us to be more like Jesus. He molds us to be like Jesus. When Jesus was here on earth, it says in Matthew chapter 10 verse 38 that He went around doing good And the Holy Spirit helps us to do good. He helps us to be more and more like Jesus every day. He helps us follow Jesus and walk like Jesus did. Jesus was kind, so he helps us be kind. Jesus was obedient, he helps us obey. Jesus is forgiving, so the Holy Spirit helps us forgive. Jesus is helpful, so the Holy Spirit helps us be helpful. Jesus is loving, so the Holy Spirit helps us love. Jesus is patient, so the Holy Spirit teaches us to be patient. Jesus is faithful, the Holy Spirit teaches us to be faithful. Jesus is gentle, the Holy Spirit teaches us to be gentle too. And that is bearing his fruit, the fruit of the Holy Spirit, which is, can you say it together, kids? Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And the last one, kids, the Holy Spirit unites believers in Jesus Christ, the church, the Christian community, and that includes you and me. Remember the song that we usually sing in church when we greet each other? We are one in the bond of love. We are one in the bond of love. We have joined our spirit with the Spirit of God. We are one in the bond of love. The Holy Spirit unites his church, and he gives each one the ability and the gifts to serve him and to glorify him. Yes, kids, the Holy Spirit does that and many more. He works in our lives to the glory of God. He is the helper whom God had promised to be with us forever. And our star verse for today is found in the book of John, chapter 16, verse 14, which says, I will ask the Father, and he will give you another helper to be with you forever. So let us thank God for the Holy Spirit, kids. Can we say it? Thank you, God, for the Holy Spirit, who is at work in our hearts, molding us and making us more and more like Jesus every day, and helping us share the good news and pointing others to Jesus. Let us do this with faith and confidence in the Holy Spirit. Amen. And for our kids' time, we are going to make a The Holy Spirit is My Helper banner craft. Here it says that the Holy Spirit gives us new life. He helps us look to Jesus. He helps us understand, remind us, and guides and teaches us God's word. And like a tree, he helps us grow and bear fruit. And he helps us be strong as God's child. If you're a boy, you draw a boy. If you're a girl, draw a girl. Or you may put your picture here in the last box. Okay, so all you need are a pair of scissors, puncher, coloring materials, yarn, colored paper or construction paper, a small piece of board paper, and a long-sized bond paper. Okay, so this is how to do it. So first you take the small piece of board paper and put in the background another color of paper. So let's get this blue one. Okay, so then put this aside. Then get your long bond paper and fold it into three. This way. Cut it And this is for this one. Then fold it into five. Okay, then open it. Then let's draw the squares. Get your pen. Then color them in until you get this, like this. Take your glue. And get your puncher. And ask your parent to help you. So there. So have fun making this craft, kids, and don't forget to post them on our Facebook page.
Songs, and after participating with all the activities with fun, Father, you taught us so much and you empowered us, especially these children of yours, Lord, we entrust to you their knowledge, their learning, their life, the fun, the joy, and everything, Father, so that in you, they and all of us will continue to grow in our journey with the Holy Spirit. Oh Lord our God, we ask that you continue to bless the children and their families, even our relatives and friends, so this becomes our witness, our testimony to your goodness. Now may the blessing of God, our Father in heaven, Jesus, our Redeemer, and the Holy Spirit who takes residence in your heart will always be with you